3 points that matter, and it puts them to the top of Group C after today's opening matches. England leading the way from Slovenia and Denmark, who drew earlier on. Serbia now with ground to make up as the group progresses, if they can. So England supporters will obviously be happy. They've got the win that they dearly wanted to get their tournament underway, but Richie, far from a convincing performance by England.
That exchange there between Dara and Ray was the crux of it. Do you focus on the result or the performance? Happy with the result if you're an England fan. It's a clean sheet by a makeshift defence, and they hung on at the end. But my God, that was a disappointing performance. We talked beforehand about the individual brilliance of the people in attack. Phil Foden, like one of the most dangerous players in the final third, created nothing. Harry Kane, European Golden Boot winner, it took him 77 odd minutes for him to have a shot on target, and that's the only one he had in the whole game. Bellingham had a lot of the ball, but the majority of it was deep in his own midfield, giving it to the nearest person. At the back there at the end, they were edgy, they were hanging on unconvincingly. There won't be any of the major teams in this tournament who look on that England performance and worry in the slightest.
Yeah. It was interesting, Ray passed a comment midway through that second half, and he said he didn't notice any discernible game plan on England's part.
Yeah.
Did you?
I couldn't disagree with it. I think the experiment with Alexander-Arnold in the middle of the park failed. I don't think we'll see him playing there again. Because you can't play a player there. Well, he's tried it once now. You can't play a player there who's never played there before. And I think the biggest issue for me, if I was an England fan, would be, now, you've got to get out of the group. We've seen Italy yesterday. Apart from Spain and Germany, there were some average performances from the big teams. But it doesn't matter how you get out of the group. So you get out of the group and the tournament starts then. My issue, my worry with England would be that apart from Saka in the first half and also times in the second half, there was no threat whatsoever. Mm. And as Richie said, Foden, non-existent today. He's had a few touches. He never influenced the game in any way in the final third. And then he takes Saka off, brings Bowen on, creates a chance, and then he leaves Foden on another 10, 12, 15 minutes. He doesn't want to make decisions. Because if he wants to play Bellingham in the position he does play, he must not play Foden. Yeah. Foden can't play because he's not a wide player. He's got in Bowen, who's done well when he came on, in Eze and in Anthony Gordon. He's got far more effective players in these positions than Foden is. And you asked me the question before, has he got too many good players? Well, I think you'd rather have more good players than less good players. But when you've got these players, you've got to make decisions.
Yeah.
And as so often with Southgate, I think he's worried or he doesn't want to make these tough calls. You know, there's only 11 who can play. And if Foden can't play in the system you want to play, he's got to go on the bench. And if he's not happy, he's got to go home. You know, it's end off. There's no two ways about it. And he won't do it. And this is my worry for England, because he'll play the next game with Foden and Bellingham, somebody else next to Declan Rice, and he'll do it time and time again, unless maybe somebody gets injured. But if he's got the option to play these two, he will.
Yeah, well, as Ray suggested towards the end of the match, still probably more questions than answers in relation to the England team. So England begin their Euro campaign on a winning note, and when Gareth Southgate and his team of analysts sit down to review that game, there won't be many highlights for them to pick out. But they can't pick out the goal because it was very well taken by Jude Bellingham.
It was very well taken. At this point in the game, England had all the possession and it was all being moved very slowly. And this is the one bit of kind of, if you can even call it, explosive play. Saka got to the byline with a bit of pace. I think the defender, Pavlovic, should have blocked the cross, but with perfect timing of Bellingham's arrival, and out jumps the defender for the goal. They deserve to go in front at that point.
OK, in the second half, Richie, they were limited to a couple of attempts on goal. Now, was that as a result of very good Serbian organisation and defence, or was it just their lack of creativity?
It was as a result of a team that had no clear sense of what it is they were being sent out to do in order to score a goal. There are lots of players who wanted to get on the ball like this. Every person on the ball had an option of someone 5 yards away, but very rarely did this happen where they actually troubled the goal. goalkeeper. That was a comfortable save from a shot from Alexander-Arnold. Bowen comes on, and one of the first things he did was attack the fullback and put a brilliant cross in, which was brilliantly saved. But that's the only contribution that Harry Kane made in the whole game where he looked like someone who might challenge the goalkeeper. It was just... we talked before about the systems and the formation and the personnel, yeah, and who goes where and to what effect. It was so bad. They looked so devoid of ideas.
And is it fair to say, Diddy, of the four teams now we've seen in Group C, that Serbia are possibly the worst of them? Because Slovenia impressed you earlier on. Denmark were OK.
Yeah.
But, Serbia created a little bit in the second half, but nothing to write home about.
I think that they didn't lose anything in defeat today. And we should also acknowledge that they did play the best team in the best team in the group tonight. So yeah. I think Serbia's got a very good chance getting out of the group.
Really?
I liked what I saw, yeah. I think they defended really well. Here they get a bit fortunate, the English. Did they create enough? No, probably not. Here, Jovic, he wants to go behind Gehi. He's got to stay in the middle of the goal and maybe just help the ball on, because that's where Tadic played the ball. This is a good shot here from Vlahovic. Runs away from goal. It's a tough shot to get some pace on the ball. I think Pickford had this cover. So there wasn't really a clear-cut chance where you say they should have scored. But they did enough to put England under pressure in the second half. And they tried everything, couldn't break them down.
But are Serbia a little bit one-dimensional in terms of the way they go about their attack? I mean, certainly throughout the first half, they were just constantly looking for Mitrovic. He was their out ball. They didn't quite pull it off.
Yeah, in the first half, they didn't create anything. But in the second half, at times, England defended very deep. And England found it very hard or almost impossible to create chances in the first half. Now, for a team like Serbia against an English team, where they've got 10 men behind the ball, 30 yards from goal, it's very hard to get through. You've got to be patient. You need a bit of guile, creativity. They didn't have that. Tadic came on. I think we've seen today he's coming to the end of his career. They didn't have the weapons to really punish him or create something.
Yeah.
It'll be different against Denmark and Slovenia. They will get more chances.
OK, Richie, were you surprised at how deep England ended up, that Serbia really pressed them on, and England ended up with 11 men in their own half for much of that second half?
Yeah, I think it was a sign of just how the game went. The longer it went on, collectively, those England players, their whatever confidence or assuredness they may have come into the tournament with, it was kind of seeping away quite rapidly as the game went on. They were, as you said, retreating. I think Alexander-Arnold was taken off because if your main priority is to defend and hang on to what you have, you don't want someone like him in the middle of the park. So he was taken off. But even at the end, there was about 92 minutes. So there's 4 minutes of injury time. Declan Rice had a free kick, 30 yards from the byline of the Serbs, and he gave it straight back to them. And you just think, even composure. Like we spoke before about Declan Rice, what he brings to the game. Yeah. Just there was a collective lack of composure as well, yeah, and game intelligence. So they were hanging on at the end against a fairly ordinary Serbia team on the back of producing the most ordinary performance you can give if you're one of the tournament favourites in the opening game.
OK, many seasoned observers, Diddy, have said that for England to go all the way in this competition, they'll need Harry Kane, Jude Bellingham and Phil Foden to be at their best. They weren't at their best tonight, were they? They've all got improvements to make.
No. I think as a team they've got improvements to make, but the thing is you've got to pick a team which gives you the best possible chance not only to win the game, but for every single player to excel and take responsibility and bring out the best in the players. Now, I felt today they picked a formation where it doesn't give them the best chance, because I don't think Alexander-Arnold should be playing there. I don't think Foden should be playing out on the wing. And the question will be, is he going to change it? I don't think he will. And this is what would be my worry for England moving forward, because he will keep the same formation as long as possible. And then the other thing is, Saka was the most influential player going forward. He's the first one coming off.
Yeah.
You know, he had to take Foden or even Kane off before that, because obviously they weren't in the game at all. And this is the question that, that the manager has to answer.
Yeah.
But as we know in the past, if he has to make a decision, you know, he drags it out as long as he can.
Yeah, briefly, Richie, and to finish up, do you think Gareth Southgate is the man who can make the decisions to improve England's performances?
Harry Kane there focused, and I think the questioner led him there. It's like, is it all about the win? And Kane was like, yeah, it's just about the win and getting out of the group. I think if internally they keep the focus only on the result, they're not going to get far in this tournament at all. They need to answer some very difficult questions and call each other out on what was a pretty abysmal night for a lot of them.
Okay.